Hi, my dear friends. Good morning. Good morning. Let's talk about another Bible lesson, and our reference will be Einstein and Chaplin. Please Google them so that you will have reference on their contribution to mankind. But I would like us to focus on a clip I've taken off Twitter, which is now X, and it goes like this. Einstein said, "What I admire most about your art is its universality. You do not say a word, and yet the world understands you." "It's true," Chaplin replied, "but your fame is even greater. The world admires you when no one understands you." Wow, that's an amazing clip. So imagine these famous characters. Even if we common people do not understand that what they're doing, but we appreciate it, right? We interpret it as something that is positive and contributory to society. That's wonderful, right? I mean, I watch Charlie Chaplin's film, they're silent films, and they're entertaining and funny. I mean, there's a little bit of, you know, falling down and everything, but it's quite entertaining considering a lot of this noise around right now in our generation. And of course, for Einstein, I'm sorry, I'm just using their last name, pardon me. Yeah, he contributed much in science that it boosts, you know, research and study. And there's nothing wrong in believing even or admiring even if sometimes we do not understand. Because it says in the Bible, as iron sharpens iron, so as one person sharpens another. Yes, it's true, my dear friends. We need each other in order for what? To survive. Because we were created social beings. So we benefit from each other through our specialized skills. Like Albert Einstein sharpened us in science. Chaplin sharpened us in terms of entertaining. And in the end, we share that joy, that understanding to others. So we complement each other. Humanity complement each other. And we are now living in a wonderful place called Earth and humanity. Wow, that's wonderful, right? But it got broken. Because normally we can sharpen each other. And goodness reigns, happiness reigns. But it was broken, my dear friends. How did, you know, the Bible says we can help each other, but where's the part where the chain got broken? And now we are experiencing what? Chaos, crimes, evil things. What happened? When it's supposed to be humanity should help each other, sharpen each other. Where did we go wrong? There was this missing link. There was this strike that destroyed the chain of goodness. Here it is. Let's study it. Wow. It all starts when we begin to not believe in God. It's true, my dear friends. It says in the Bible, some people say in their heart, there's no God. And then, what happens? Corruption starts to begin. And when the mind is corrupted with that idea, actions of evil starts. And nothing good will come out from it. Wow, my dear friends. Imagine, God created Adam and Eve so that they can supplement each other and have a stronger relationship with God. It was broken because sin came in. And then doubt came in. And then now, in our current generation, we hear people saying there's no God. From the first verse in Proverbs that says we help each other, complement each other, make humanity better, make this earth a better world to live in, got broken because they disconnected themselves to God. They say now there is no God and then corruption begins, evil action begins. Check it out. Meditate in our heart, my dear friends. That's how it started. Let's go on. It says here, you can Google this, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. But fools, okay, despise wisdom and instruction. There you go. No wonder we're so troubled. We disconnected ourselves from God. And when we do that, we disconnect ourselves from knowledge, from understanding. Then the sin begins. Chaos, envy, pride, greed begins, as written in the Bible. Sometimes we rely now on our own understanding because we already disconnected the true knowledge. That's God. And when we get disconnected, we rely on human knowledge. And that gave us troubles. Why? The wisdom of this world is foolishness, my dear friends. Apart from God, our knowledge is foolishness and sinful. Apart from God, we are gonna be in trouble. That's what we're experiencing right now, my dear friends. Remember, the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord. When you say the fear of the Lord, it's the respect for God. It's that we believe that God is able. We believe that God is a God of action. And when we stop believing that, we disconnect from God. We end up saying, there is no God, because we're already disconnected from God. When we say there is no God, it means that we do not believe that He is able or He is a God of action. That's still saying there is no God because you do not fear His capability. And that is what? Sin. It corrupts the mind. And then when we're apart from God, it says in the verse, we rely on the foolishness of the wisdom of this world. There you go. That's what happens. Instead of man sharpening man, helping each other, we forget the formula for that peaceful connection is God. We end up destroying it. That's why in our last verse it says here, Proverbs 3:13, happy is the man that findeth wisdom, and the man that getteth understanding. And the quotation from this clip from the web is, happiness may be humanity's greatest desire. Men and women have always been looking for that which will make them happy. And now we know, happiness is wisdom. But not the wisdom of this world, because it's foolishness. It's the wisdom, the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Connection to God. And then we can fulfill the one that's in Proverbs. So as iron sharpens on iron, so as man sharpens a man. So I hope this example helps us understand the true meaning of wisdom and why wisdom fled away, because we did not believe in God anymore. And when that happens, corruption comes in, sin comes in. That's why we are experiencing all of this around us. The not so good things. So my dear Christians, my appeal to everybody is one. Stay strong. Do not let go of your faith in God. This world needs light bearers like you and me. We cannot stop doing good, influencing good, because the devil is like a roaring lion seeking someone he wants to devour. The devil doesn't have any days off. That's why we as Christians, instrument for God, you and me, should not stop making this world a better place, my dear friends. It's worth it. Living a lifetime, maybe we could last 70 years old, helping, making this world a better place in exchange for eternal happiness with God. In Jesus' name. God bless everybody. Have a nice day.